Thank you very much, and everybody's, we've got a lot of nice comments on that song right there. Well, it's time to ring out another one of my hobo honeys, ladies and gentlemen. This lady was with us all last year. You talk about, you've heard, you know, there's talent, and then there's double talent, and there's triple talent. This lady has triple talent, and you're fixing to find out and get a good old belly laugh. Would you please welcome Miss Patty Davidson and her little friends?
I'm Patty. This is my friend Dan. Yes, hello out there. I'm Dan.
To all you foxy ladies out there tonight, I am Dan, the man.
And this is my friend Lucy.
Hi! She's dead. Gum, her mouth is big.
I do not have a big mouth. I have a small, feminine mouth.
You do not? You have a mouth like a cave.
I do not.
You do so, say ah.
I will not.
I dare you to say ah.
Only one time.
Hello, 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 hello. All right.
All right. Thank you. We're here tonight to talk about the game of baseball. Now, Major League Baseball is played on a diamond.
So does that mean that minor league ball is played on a cubic zirconia?
Oh, brother. Baseball is simply a grown-up version of Monopoly. The players throw the ball. They run all over the board. If their attorneys have negotiated a good deal, they get to pass go and collect the $1 million.
Well, how come women don't play baseball?
Because women hate to show up at an event where 20 other people are wearing the same outfit.
Well, did you know that they're giving ball players really weird names nowadays? On my softball team, who's on first, what's on second, I don't know is on third.
Well, since we're talking about it, why don't you go ahead and tell us the names of the kids on your softball team?
No, I just told you. Who's on first, what's on second, I don't know is on third.
Do you know the kids' names?
Yes.
Well, then who's on first base?
Yes.
I mean the kid's name on first base on your softball team.
Who?
The kid's name on first base on your softball team.
Who?
The kid on first.
Who is on first?
What are you asking us for?
No, I'm not asking you. I'm telling you who is on first.
Well, we're asking you who is on first.
That's the kid's name.
That's whose name?
Yes.
Go ahead, tell us.
Who?
The kid on first.
Who? The kid on first.
Who is on first?
My gosh. Do you have a first baseman on first?
Yes.
Well, all we're trying to find out is what's the kid's name on first base?
No, what's on second?
We're not asking you who is on second.
Who is on first?
That's what we're trying to find out.
Well, then don't change the players around.
We're not changing anybody around.
All right, take it easy.
All right, take it easy. What's the kid's name on first base?
What's the kid's name on second?
We're not asking you who is on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
She's on third base. We're not even talking about her.
How did we get on third base?
Well, Lucy just mentioned her name.
If I mentioned third baseman's name, heaven forbid, then what did I say third baseman's name is?
No, what's on second?
We're not asking you who is on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
Do you have an outfield?
Why, certainly.
Do you have a good outfield?
Absolutely.
The left fielder's name.
Why?
The
I don't know. Just thought I'd ask.
Just thought I'd tell you.
Then tell us, what's the kid's name in left field? What's on second? We're not asking you who is on second.
Who is on first?
I don't know.
Third base.
She's dead. The left fielder's knee.
Why?
Because
she's in center field.
Wait a minute. Do you have a pitcher on this team?
Well, wouldn't this be a fine team without a pitcher?
Tell us the pitcher's name.
Tomorrow.
You don't want to tell us today?
I'm telling you.
Go right ahead.
Tomorrow.
What time?
What time what?
What time tomorrow are you going to tell us who's pitching?
Now look, who is not pitching?
Who is? I'll break your arm if you say who is on first.
Then why come up here and ask me?
We want you to tell us what's the guy's name pitching.
What? And if he was on second.
Who is on first?
I don't. Third base. She's dang. Dang, her mouth is big. All right. Do you have a catcher?
Yes.
The catcher's name?
Today.
Today's catching, tomorrow's pitching.
Now you've got it.
That's all you got on your team is a couple of days.
Well, I can't help it. What do you want me to do?
You have a catcher.
Yes.
Lucy's a good catcher.
I know that.
I'd like to play for your team.
Well, I might be able to arrange that.
Good, I'd like to catch. Now, I'm catching. Tomorrow's pitching.
Uh-huh.
Tomorrow throws the ball, the guy bumps the ball.
And me being a good catcher, I want to throw one out at first base. So, I throw the ball to who?
That's the first thing you've said right.
We don't even know what we're talking about.
Well, that's all you've got to do.
I throw the ball to first base.
Yes.
Now, who's got it?
Naturally.
Who has it?
Naturally.
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 I throw the ball to naturally.
You throw it to who?
Naturally.
Naturally, we'll say it that way.
That's what I'm saying.
She throws the ball to first base. Whoever it is grabs the ball as it guards to second. Who picks up the ball? Throws it to what? What does it to? I don't know. I don't know. Throws it back till tomorrow. It's a triple play.
Yes, it could be.
Huh?
Another guy's up. It's a long, flat ball to center field. Why?
I don't know.
And I don't care.
What did she say?
She said, I don't care.
Well, that's our shortstop. Oh.
Where is that hobo boxcar anyway? Get us out of this mess.
Hobo. Did you all know that hobo is the Spanish word for wolf?
No, lobo.
Huh?
Lobo is the Spanish word for wolf.
Yeah, sure.
Yes.
Well, then hobo must be the Spanish word for a gay wolf.
No, no. No, Dan, a hobo is someone who travels throughout the world. I mean, someone like Boxcar Willie.
And I love Boxcar Willie. He is a real man's man.
What do you mean by that?
Well, I love his commanding voice. His gruff exterior.
Gruff exterior? The man's a hobo. A filthy bum.
Oh, he's filthy, all right. Filthy rich. Well, you know, the man's done a lot of travel, and so have I myself. I've been to New York and Tennessee and Alabama.
Now, look, I've been a few places myself.
Well, so have I. But, honey, I've been everywhere. I've been everywhere, man.
No, I've been everywhere.
Across the deserts bare, man.
I breathe the mountain air.
Well, I've traveled, I've done my share, man. I've been everywhere. Where have you been? Reno, Chicago, Fargo, Minnesota, Buffalo, Toronto, Wayne, Louisville, Sarasota, Wichita, Tulsa, Ottawa, Oklahoma, Tampa, Panama, Manama, Rapid City,
Baltimore, out the door, and the early Duke, the old Aaron, the old Arnadilla, I'm a killer. I've been everywhere, man.
No, I've been everywhere. Crawl the deserts there, man.
I breathe the mountain air.
Well, I've traveled, I've done my share, man. I've been everywhere.
Oh, yeah, well, where have you been?
You're gonna have to help me with this one. Austin, Charleston, Layton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston,
Texarkana,
Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Chemical, Glen Rock, Black Rock, Little Rock, Arkansas, Tennessee,
Hennessey,
Jumbo Key, Spirit Lake,
Grand Lake,
Great Lake, Double Lake,
but for sake, I've been everywhere, man.
No, I've been everywhere. Across the deserts, there, man,
I breathe the mountain air.
Well, I've traveled, I've done my share, man.
I've been everywhere.
Oh, yeah?
That's right.
I've been there faster.
Oh, yeah?
That's right.
Speed her up, David. Oh, yeah. Oh, I like a locomotive. Choke on it, Davey.
Austin, Charleston, Layton, Louisiana, Washington, Houston, Kingston, Texarkana, Monterey, Faraday, Santa Fe, Tahlequah, Glen Rock,
Black Rock,
Little Rock, Arkansas, Tennessee,
Tennessee,
Jumbo Key, Spirit Lake,
Grand Lake,
Red Lake, Double Lake, the Peach Lake,
I've been everywhere, man.
We've been everywhere. Across the desert's lair, man,
we breathe the mountain air.
We've traveled, we've done our share, man.
We've been
everywhere.
Miss Patty Davidson. Have you had fun so far? You know, Patty is on the video that we have for sale here at the theater of our whole show tonight. And by the way, the first 15 people can take them home with them because we make 15 of them at once. And the rest of it, if you'd like to have a copy of tonight's show, we'll either order it, send it by mail, or you can pick it up in the morning. And in addition to that, Patty has a whole hour video of her complete program. And she's got a couple other little characters on there she don't have time to do on this show. And she'll be out in the lobby out there after the show, so pick one of them up, okay? Right now, we're going to get these Texas twin fiddles all warmed up. Ladies and gentlemen, here's one called Sally Was a Gooden. Or Sally Gooden. Thank you. Charlie Brown and his faithful fiddle Snoopy, and Todd Cook and his faithful fiddle Lucy. Ladies and gentlemen, I believe that the brain can absorb more than what the bottom can withstand. And with that in mind, it's about time for an intermission. All during intermission, I'm going to be at this table right down here in front of the bandstand. If you want to bring your souvenirs down, I'll be happy to autograph them for you. And if you want to take pictures, just go ahead, but I'll pose with you for pictures in the lobby after the show, okay? Right now, get up, stretch your legs, move about. If you'd like to have a copy of tonight's show video, see Larry Bayless in the lobby during intermission or after the show, either one. And David and Mary Lou will be over at this souvenir stand. Chuck will be out in the lobby. Get up and stretch your legs, move about, and I'm going to be at this table right here signing autographs for the next 25 minutes. Glad to have you. We want to welcome some fellow entertainers that's here with us tonight, and they're also going to be appearing on our show this coming Sunday, which is the Drug Task Force show. Every theater in town will be represented here at this theater right here this Sunday, and it's for the 6-County Drug Task Force show. And everybody's name, whose names you see up on theaters up and down the strip, will be here. We've got over 20 entertainers who are coming to the show. And that's this Sunday at 2 o'clock. And all proceeds, not a penny will be taken out for expenses or anything. All the money that's generated will go to the 6-County Drug Task Force here. And with our expansion in our beautiful little city, sometimes comes the dregs. With the dregs comes the drugs. And we're going to try to put a stop to it before it ever gets started in the little town of Branson. So that's why we've got this big show coming up. Make welcome Mr. Joe Tinoco from the Blondes, Blondes, Blondes show over here at Christie Lane Theater. Joe, where are you at? Way in the back there. And also David Peel from Silver Dollar City. And they'll be here also this Sunday for our show. David, where are you at, my boy? I don't see you. There he is, way back there. Good to have y'all here. Let me see what else I got. Pat and her group from Grand Rapids, Minnesota here tonight. Where you at, Pat, with your group from Grand Rapids, Minnesota? Good to have y'all here tonight. Everybody slowly making their way down the aisles. We'll be ready to go here before you know it. Ladies and gentlemen, if you have a camera after the show, I'll be in the lobby, and then I'll go over to the museum, and if you want to take pictures, just take all you want. But if you didn't bring a camera and you'd like to have a picture made with old Hobo, we have a Polaroid service back there, and the lady will take our picture, okay? Now listen, tomorrow morning, y'all going to be hungry. I want to tell you the best place in Branson to go eat. Right over here at the Plantation Restaurant. They got a buffet about as long as this stage here. You never seen such a breakfast buffet in all your life. Go over and tell Don I sent you over there. And don't put it on my bill, okay? But I'm telling you what, it's the best food you've ever had. I seen some of you eating supper over there tonight. Plantation. And, of course, the Pizza Hut will be open right after our show gets off tonight. And also Mickey Gillies will be open across the street over there in case you're looking for something to eat. Did y'all ride the ducks? A lot of fun riding them ducks, isn't it? Be sure and take one of our order forms home with you. It's our little catalog, and it lists all our souvenirs and all the things that we have for sale. How many of you ever been on a Caribbean cruise on a ship? Wonderful. How many of you like to go back again? Well, how many of you like to go with me? All right. That's good. Me and Shotgun Red and Ralph Emery, Brenda Lee and Johnny Russell, we're going to take a cruise on January the 9th through the 16th in 1994, and we'll be on the luxurious Costa Romantica. It's a brand new ship, and we'll be out there. Ralph Emery from Nashville now, me, Brenda Lee, Shotgun Red, and Johnny Russell. And if you'll pick up one of these little pieces of paper right here and take it home with you and fill it out, and we'd appreciate it and love to have you come go with us. We'll have a lot of fun. We're all going to entertain on the ship, and mostly we're going to eat. If you've never been on one of those cruises, they are something else. I'd like to remind you that there is no smoke in the lobby after the show. Did you go see the museum? Anybody here go to the museum next door? Was it worth it? For you folks who've never been to the museum, this man said right here, it's worth it very much. It's one of the best buys in Branson, ladies and gentlemen. There is so much to see. Like I told you, we've got Jimmy Rogers' guitar over there. All his stuff had come out of the Blue Yodeler's mansion. I've got so much railroad memorabilia. I've even got a whole cockpit of a KC-97 tanker airplane over there. You can go inside the airplane. Got a great big display of Roy Rogers' thing. And don't miss the mirror train. There's a mirror train. It's about 3 feet long, about a foot high, completely made out of mirrors. Now, let me see. I want to welcome Chuck's Travel from Tyler, Texas, here with us tonight. Travel Lanteers from East Peoria, Illinois. Thomas Tears from Wisconsin and Minnesota. Bobby Green Tears from Grand Forks, North Dakota. Rockwood International Chapter of the FMCA are here with us tonight. Where are they at? Okay. The Greenwood Travelers from Greenwood, New York. All right. Mr. and Mrs. Royce Hill from Illinois are celebrating 36 years of wedded bliss. Where are they at? Okay. Don and Agnes Hammerl, 39 years also. Peter and Jackie Varhel, 41 years. And Gretchen and Peter Kruger, is that right? I don't know what this is, and Dorothy Abramson from Bob Thomas Tears. They didn't say what y'all was celebrating. Birthdays, okay, happy birthday to everybody. See, there y'all are, aren't you pretty? This tape, ladies and gentlemen, is broadcast quality tape, and the reason it looks a little faded out up there is because the lights are on in here. And that's the most beautiful picture when you get it on your TV screen at home you've ever seen. I what? I lied? What did I lie about, sir? Oh, you can't pick them up tomorrow, Larry? Okay, I'm sorry, I did lie. Why can't they pick them up tomorrow? Huh? There must be a reason we can't pick them up tomorrow. Normally you can.
Well, that's what I was told from downstairs.
Huh?
That's what I was told from downstairs.
What do you mean that's what you was told from downstairs? Okay, well, this is an internal problem I can see right now. Well, I know we can mail them to you. It'll probably beat you home, yeah, because we send it next day or whatever it is. I got time for about a minute's worth of questions. Anybody got any questions? Hold up your hand, I'll point you out and they'll answer it. Yes, ma'am. He'll be with us in a week or so, okay? Okay. Yes, ma'am. I sing Hobo Bill. I done sing two of Jimmy Rogers' songs. I don't want to overdo old Jim. Next. You can't overdo him, okay? Who else? Yes, sir. Nobody's Darling But Mine. I'll try to get that on for you. I love that song. One of the prettiest songs ever wrote, I do believe. Yes, ma'am.
Sing another George Jones song.
Sing another George Jones. You're the lady who wrote that lighter, huh? There she is, right there. Who else got a question? Yes, ma'am. Hank Williams, I'm fixing to do something for you here. Okay. We're fixing to do something for you, okay? Beg pardon? How about some of my good songs, huh? Well, I'm sorry I picked out all my bad ones tonight. Like what, sir? Huh? Oh, well, we did that on Boxcar Blues. That was on that album. Yeah. Yeah, that was one of them on the album, Boxcar Blues. Yes, sir. We're going to have President Bush come back? He is still my president. I just thought I'd put that out so everybody know where I stand. Huh? I live here in Branson, Missouri. I've lived here for 8 years. Yes, ma'am. Or Ahab to Arab, if you'll let her know when you're coming next time, she'll do it for you, okay? She does Ahab there. Yeah, way back there. Well, bless your heart. I'll do something special for you, okay? This next Hank Williams song will be for you. And you can dedicate, it'll be 20 years from now, you'll dedicate this to your husband, okay? They just got married. Give them a big round of applause. One more question. We got to run. Give them a big round of applause. 50 years there. I'm going to turn the mic over to Chisa out here. She's going to talk at you just a minute.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, Boxcar Willie, ladies and gentlemen. He said, take my time. Glad y'all are here. I've met a lot of you on the bus this afternoon, tonight when you came in. Welcome to Boxcar Willie's show. I've known Boxcar Willie and his family for almost 20 years now, and he's just what you see. He's genuine. And after the show, if you have questions now that you're thinking about, you want to ask him, he'll stay till the last cow goes home and talk to you. So stick around. The lady that asked for the Hank Williams tune will dedicate this to you. This is our tribute to one of the greatest country singers ever that lived. You cannot do a real live traditional country show without including a Hank Williams song. A lot of folks say that Boxcar Willie does great tributes to Hank. I think he does the very, very best. In fact, when Boxcar starts singing Hank Williams tunes, you feel like maybe Hank's still around somewhere.
Sounds too blue to fly. The midnight train is whining. I'm so lonesome I could cry. Did you ever see the robin weep when leaves begin to die? That means he's lost the will to live. I'm so lonesome I could cry. The silent song of falling stars lights up a purple sky. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so night so still when when time goes crawling by. And as I'm wondering where you are, I'm so lonesome I could cry. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
A tribute to Hank Williams, Boxcar Willie, ladies and gentlemen. Boxcar Willie, Hank Williams.
We need a faster curtain, don't we? It's getting old. Getting up and down the best it can. When you reach about 60, it's hard to get up and down, you know. So my old curtain, same way. I want to bring out another one of my hobo honeys. She's been singing background all night long. But she's a star in her own right, ladies and gentlemen, and I know you're going to live. For 7 years, she was with Whispering Bill Anderson on the Grand Ole Opry, and she's been with me now 7 years. Please welcome pretty Mary Lou Turner.
Thank you. Thank you, Bob. Thank you all. Women have played an important part in country music through the years. Some of them have become legends, and you don't even have to mention their names because their songs speak for them. Like the queen of country music. It wasn't God who made honky tonk angels, as you said in the words of your song. Too many times married men think they're still single, and that's caused many a good girl to go wrong. And the country sunshine girl, I was raised on country sunshine, green grass beneath my feet, running through fields of daisies, wading through the creek. I love you, please believe me, I wouldn't want you to ever leave me. But I was raised on country sunshine, and from the cotton fields of Alabama, she went on to become the first lady of country music. Stand by your man, give him two arms to cling to, and something warm come to when nights are cold and long. Stand by your man and show the world you love him. Keep giving all the love you can. Stand by your man. And from Winchester, Virginia, she was the greatest of them all. Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy, crazy for feeling. As long as you wanted, then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. I'm crazy for trying, crazy for crying, and I'm
Ladies and gentlemen. Oh, that's fantastic.
Woo!
Won't that give you spooky when you look up there and see Patsy and Dottie's picture? We're so saddened by Dottie, because we knew Dottie better than we did Patsy. The last Grand Ole Opry show that Dottie was on, I was the one that introduced her on stage. And give Mary Lou another round of applause. I just like that. Darling, get your other fiddle. Put your mandolin down for just a minute. Somebody asked for a very pretty song out there that we recorded about 2 years ago, and it's been recorded so many times, but I thought we got a pretty good cut on it too. And we want to do it for it. It's written by the great Jimmy Davis, the former governor of Louisiana, who also wrote You Are My Sunshine. He wanted to hear Nobody's Darling But Mine. Come and sit by my side, little darling. Come lay your cool hand on my brow. Promise me that you will never be nobody's darling but mine. Nobody's darling but mine, love. Be honest, be faithful, be kind. Promise me that you will never I appreciate it. Last year, I got to go on the trip of a lifetime, ladies and gentlemen. I've been around the world several times, but I got to take a dream vacation. I'd always wanted to go to Africa where the animals are. And last November, my wife and I got to go to East Africa, right down below the equator in Kenya. And we spent 13 nights in the jungles of Africa, camped out along the banks of the Massamera River. Animals, you've never seen so many animals in all your life. And at night, the sounds of the jungle, ooh, it's beyond compare. We were right at the foot of Mount Kilimanjaro, and there was a full moon one night shining down on the snow-capped mountain. Our good friend here from Branson, the world-renowned author Janet Daly, was on the trip with us. She said, you ought to write a song called A Kilimanjaro Breakdown. And we had these natives with spears guarding our camp. That's all. We were 80 miles from the nearest light bulb. And they were guarding our camp at night by fire, and they carried spears. And so I started humming this song. And this native started patting his foot and kind of singing, you know, how they do. And I wrote the Kilimanjaro Breakdown, and here it is right now. I've got that spear. I don't have it in the museum yet, but I bought that spear off that native for $2. And I'll put it in the museum pretty soon over there. When I got back, I lost it. We just found it yesterday. So we'll have it in there. Anybody wants to see it, I'll go down to the office and get it after the show. It's what they kill the lions with. They don't use guns. They use spears. We were in very primitive country, let me tell you. You know what? I love to do imitations of country music stars. People always tell me that, Boxcar, we know exactly who you're doing whenever you do it. That's because I tell them who I'm going to do before I do it. Removes all doubt. And I like to do people with handles like Whispering Bill Anderson. Still, though I broke your heart, still, though we're far. Thank you. Now, two of my favorite people to do and imitate are the Outlaws. You know who the Outlaws are? Waylon and Willie. Oh, I need a hat for old Waylon. Well, a long time forgotten.
dream that just fades away. Well, the love that you promised, you know, but you can't hear today. Willie. Kind of makes you wish you'd paid more for your ticket, don't it? But she never complained of the bad times, of the bad things he done. Just talks about the good times, all the good times to come. You notice I'm doing people with handles. I also do Roy Acuff, Smoky Mountain Boy, Texas Troubadour, Ernest Tubb, Gambler Kenny Rogers. Listen, who would you say I was going to imitate if I said I was going to imitate the man in black? Nope, Charlie Pride. Of course, it's Johnny Cash. John's a good friend of mine, but friend or no friend, he makes the worst train sound I ever heard. Wah, wah! You ever been to a Johnny Cash concert and watched him walk out on stage? Why, if I had a dog acted like that, I'd worm him.
Hello, I'm Johnny Cash.
Paula!
I hear the train a coming, rolling around a bend.
Scoobity wah, scoobity wah, scoobity wah, scoobity wah, scoobity wah, scoobity wah, scoobity
wah. Scoobity wah.
Yeah, scoobity-wop. That's it.
Hey, man, I happen to be doing one of my classic train songs.
Well, I was putting a little classic background in there for you.
I don't remember scoobity-wop being in the song.
Well, it should have been. I'd have sold more records if it had.
We'll just leave that part out, June. I hear the train a-coming, rolling around a bend.
Oom-bop-a, 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 jailbird. Oom-bop-a, oom-bop-a, bird.
Now what is it?
Oom-bop-a.
Oh, that's it? You got it?
Don't you know the only time you ever say oom-bop-a is if I'm doing a polka song?
Well, it's your song, whatever you want to do on it. Matter to me.
Well, do I look like the six fat Dutchmen?
Two or three of them. My, my.
I don't want no scoobity wops.
No scoobity wops.
I don't want no mmm papas.
Mmm papa. Well, how about a cha cha cha?
Hey, that'll work.
Yeah.
Under one condition.
I know it'll work. I've been working. Condition. Condition. What kind of condition you talk?
You just need to be a little further in the background.
How far?
Try Chattanooga.
Thank you.
I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. Well, I'm stuck in Folsom Prison. Time keeps dragging on. While that train keeps rolling down the San Antonio.
Hit it, Luther.
Rich folks dining in a fancy dining car, probably smoking coffee, drinking big cigars. He said I didn't sing that right. Oh, what the heck.
Made the same mistake last night.
Whoa, whoa!
All I got to say is John is my friend as long as he never sees this act. Hey, here's one of the prettiest songs in country music. The old hometown looks the same as a step down from the train. There to meet me was my
What do you think you're doing?
Nothing. I just got here.
I can see that, but why'd you go back there and get drunk?
We're gonna sing. You won't let me
sing. They don't want to hear a drunk sing.
Yeah, they do.
The only reason they applauded, they just want me to pacify you.
Well, pacify me.
Get your guitar, I'll pacify you. Never hear Foster Brooks getting requests to sing. I don't know why he thinks he should. Oh, why me, Lord?
Oh, no.
Why me?
Well, you sang it wrong anyway.
You know the right words.
I'll have you know I sang this song just the way Tom Jones recorded it.
That ain't the way I wrote it.
You wrote this song?
I did. I wrote it down on a piece of paper. The old hometown looks upside down when you're laying on the ground. There's the old freight train that I just fell off of. Down the lane I look and there runs Bessie. Good old cow, but she's kind of messy. When you're lying in the green, green grass of home.
Hey! Where did you get this?
I never leave home without it.
Harlan, you can't drink in front of these nice people right here.
I ain't drank with me. I don't care.
They don't want to drink with you. Besides. Oh, my goodness. Oh, you can't drink your stuff.
Oh, why not?
This stuff is very dangerous to your health.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Well, it is, and I love you, and tell you what, I'm going to give you a little demonstration. Just try to save your life, and I'll bet you never take another drink long as you live.
Well, I guess maybe then on the other hand. And then I was going to tell you one other thing, when everybody slipped my mind, because I had to go all the way back over there, and by the time I got back, well, I just didn't even know where I...
Okay.
Ain't that one of Bill Clinton's old speeches? Look, I'll take two water glasses.
Two water glasses.
Fill one up with this old nasty whiskey.
Okay, let's drink it.
No, we ain't gonna drink it. Fill the other water glass up with good old pure water.
Oh, pure water, okay.
I'll take an ordinary worm.
Ordinary worm.
Put the little worm in the water.
Put it in the water.
Look at him.
I see him.
He's swimming.
I know.
He's healthy.
Yep.
He's happy and gay.
I know he's happy. He's never going ever. He's going to go start a crawl. Gay. You mean the worm turned?
I'll take a little worm out of the water.
Out of the water?
Put him in the whiskey.
Put him in the whiskey, right.
Now look at him.
He's drinking my whiskey. What are you doing?
He took one sip and he's dead.
Dead?
Yes, he's dead. Now what does that prove to you?
Proves to me that if I keep drinking whiskey...
That's right.
I won't ever have worms.
No! Harlan Powell. I grew up singing hymns. And the first songs that I ever learned to sing were hymns. And seems like one of the first songs I ever learned was this next one. We got it on our gospel album. And why don't y'all join in and help us sing Life's Railway to Heaven. Life is like a mountain railway with its engineer that's great. We must make the run successful from the cradle to the grave. Watch the curves of fields and trestles never falter, never quail. Keep your hand upon the throttle and your eye on the rail. Blessed Savior, that will guide us till we reach the blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in thy praise. Spanning jar and swelling tide, you'll behold the Union Depot into which your train will glide. There you'll meet the superintendent, God the Father, the heart to welcome strangers, will repel from welcome home. Blessed Savior, that will guide us till we reach that blissful shore where the angels wait to join us in thy praise forever.
you.
We lost a dear friend in country music last year, ladies and gentlemen, a man who was my personal friend, a man who was responsible for getting me on the Grand Ole Opry. I sat in his dressing room at the Grand Ole Opry 2 or 3 years ago, and he said, "I want you to promise me that you'll never let this next song die that I'm about to do for you." His name was Roy Claxton Acuff. The song was the Wabash Cannonball. To the queen of flowing mountain by the Southville by the shore. She's mighty tall and handsome and on Quentville by hole. She's a combination of the Wabash Cannonballs. Them twin Texas Stradivarius. States are dandy, so the people always say. From New York to St. Louis and Chicago by the way. From the hills of Minnesota where the rippling waters fall. No changes can be taken on the Wabash Cannonball. Charles Anderson Jennings and that Fender Stratocaster electric guitar. She rolled into Birmingham one cold December day. As she pulled into the station, you could hear all the people say, "There's a gal out there from Branson. She's long and she's tall. She's a combination of the Wabash Cannonball." David Byrd and that beautiful Kimball piano. Kimball pianos come from Indiana, the home of the Wabash Cannonballs. Gentlemen, on behalf of the whole cast of our show, Charlie Brown on one fiddle down here, Todd Cook on the other, and Harlan Powell on the steel guitar, Brad Alvin on the bass fiddle, Wee Tiny Wayne Bennett on the drums back there, Chuck Jennings on the lead guitar, David Byrd on the piano, Mary Lou Turner, one of our hobo honeys, and our other two hobo honeys, Cheeside Childs and Patty Davidson. And for our sound and light men, give them a big round of applause. Don't they do a good job? That's Bert and Ernie back there. I'm going to the lobby. If you'd like to come by the lobby and get an autograph, take pictures, and I'm going over to the museum. And I'd love to see you over to the museum over there. You have something that you will really enjoy. And Boxcar Willie, I'll give you my scout's honor. You're going to enjoy that museum. God bless and good night, everybody. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Boxcar Willie. Boxcar Willie.
Good night, folks. Drive careful.
America's favorite hobo. Give another great big hand, Mr. Boxcar Willie.